And as luck would have it, it was just the kind of snow Stan Brzezinski's hoped it would be.
It's light, it's not very hard packed, it's easy to move around, so it's not too bad. It's just a heck of a lot of it.
After all that hard work, all there was left to do was enjoy this winter wonderland. Here in Vernon, New Jersey, more than 2 feet of powdery, fluffy snow. It's fluffy. Very fluffy. Which didn't go unnoticed by skiers in Vernon who flocked to Mountain Creek. Fresh from the slopes of Vermont, Dawn Bauer swears this powder is even better.
Awesome. It's sick. Oh my gosh, there's so much snow, no ice. It's so soft, doesn't even hurt if you fall. It's great.
Best skiing they've ever had here in 3 years. This is wonderful.
And for each trodden, plowed, or shoveled path, there were fields of alabaster untouched. A postcard picture at every turn.
This is what I moved up here for. You know, the heavy snow and everything, winter wonderland type of thing.
With tomorrow being New Year's Day, a holiday, that means an extra day for kids and grown-ups to enjoy all the snow. And for procrastinators, an extra day to dig out the car. In Hamburg, New Jersey, Aimee Nuzzo, CBS 2.
Digging out after the storm proved deadly in Westchester County. Two elderly men suffered heart attacks while shoveling snow. County officials tell us most of the roads there are clear tonight. Tomorrow, buses are on a Sunday schedule because of the holiday. And the airport in Westchester is open. And we're told the New Year's Eve celebration at the county center is underway as planned.
We know it is chilly everywhere and crowded in Times Square, but what are those exact weather conditions, Mr. Pann?
That's what I'm here for, to give you the exact weather
conditions.
Good. I tell you what can help out with some really cold temperatures. 500,000 people standing in the
You're
same
right.
place.
Little body warm it up.
At the same time. Right, let's take a few pictures from down in Times Square. 500,000 people in the same spot. It does help. The wind chills are going to be below zero. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? I always love looking at that.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'd like standing there, but I always like looking at it. Beautiful shots from down at Times Square right there. Here's a look at our forecast for midnight, just a little under an hour from now. Temperatures be in the mid-20s. Winds will be kicking up out of the northwest, gusting up to 20, 25 miles per hour. And at times, the wind chill will be approaching 10 degrees below zero. No snow in the forecast. There's actually a few snow flurries in our northern suburbs, but I don't think we'll see any of that here in the city. We'll have the five-day forecast coming up in just a few minutes, and I think you're going to like it. It's cold, but at least there's no snow in sight all the way down the road.
Beggars can't be choosy.
Exactly.
Thanks, Tony.
You know, he almost sounded disappointed there isn't snow in the forecast.
Was that what we heard in your voice?
Wouldn't that have been fun if we had the snowstorm today?
It would have been interesting.
Only a meteorologist would get away with that.
I know.
Thanks, Tony.
Okay, guys.
2000, what a year. Ringing in the new year, of course, means taking a look back at the past year, and we will do just that.
And unrest in the Middle East with local ties, a rabbi, the son of an Israeli extremist, is gunned down in the West Bank.
We now know the first team the Giants need to beat to get to the Super Bowl. A look ahead to next Sunday and more in sports.
And we're going to keep returning to Times Square, the crossroads of the world, as the clock counts down and the minutes are running out. Stay with us.
News on CBS 2 is brought to you by Mitsubishi, the digital big screen company.
If you're watching Brett Favre on an ordinary television, you're missing a lot of action. Get a Mitsubishi widescreen HD TV with a picture so real, so clear, you won't miss a thing. Get a Mitsubishi HD TV and pay absolutely nothing for 12 months.
Get it right at the Wiz.
Celebrate the Jeep year-end clearance with Noisemakers. A little bubbly and exceptional values on legendary Jeep 4x4s, like Cherokee Sport. Buy one with 3.9% APR and save over $3,000 in financing. Or returning Daimler Chrysler lessees with preferred credit can lease one for just $249 a month. So ring in the new year at the Jeep year-end clearance with great values and, of course, the obligatory fireworks. Check one out at your Jeep dealer.
Just in case you were wondering, New York will be open for the holidays. And the best way to get to it all? MTA, New York City Transit, Long Island Railroad, Long Island Bus, and Metro North Railroad. One system that gets you where you want to go. And with MetroCard, faster, easier, and less expensive. MTA, going your way.
In a place that had lost its passion, one woman is breaking all the rules. Now nominated for 4 Golden Globe Awards, including Best Picture of the Year. Chocolat.
My favorite.
I knew that.
Rated PG-13. Now playing.
Protest today in the Middle East and in Manhattan after the son of Israeli extremist Rabbi Meir Kahana was killed. Benjamin Kahana and his wife were gunned down while traveling in their car in the West Bank. CBS 2 reporter David Diaz has the latest.
Though he was known as a quiet, introverted man, 34-year-old Benjamin Kahane had followed in the radical anti-Arab footsteps of his father. And like his father, Benjamin apparently was gunned down as he traveled with his family on this road near where he lived in a controversial settlement in the West Bank. His wife, Talia, who was riding in the van with him, was also killed. 5 of their children who were also in the vehicle were wounded, 1 seriously. A Palestinian group is claiming responsibility for the bloody attack. The incident touched off protests by Kahana supporters both in Israel and here in Manhattan, in front of the Israeli consulate. Both here and in Israel, the protesters blame the government of Ehud Barak for the attack.
Because had they listened to Rabbi Meir Kahana and to his son Benjamin Kahana and expelled the murderous Arabs from Israel, there would be no Jews murdered on the roads because there'd be no Arabs in Israel to murder them.
The elder Kahane, who founded the militant and violent Jewish Defense League in Brooklyn, eventually settled in Israel, where he formed the Kach movement, which advocated getting all Arabs out of Israel by force if necessary.
There is no such thing as an Arab village in the state of Israel. It is a Jewish village that is temporarily inhabited by Arabs.
10 years ago last month, Meir Kahane was here at the New York Sheraton Hotel delivering a speech to his American Jewish supporters when he was assassinated. An Egyptian-born U.S. citizen who was in the audience was charged with his murder. Now, Kahane's son, who founded the Kahane Chai movement, meaning Kahane lives, has also been murdered. A Palestinian spokeswoman said today of Kahane and his followers, quote, "They send Israelis to take Palestinian land, and they cry foul if they are injured or if they are killed." David Diaz, CBS 2.
An historic sale in the Far East has ended abruptly. A tourist boat left Taiwan headed for mainland China, ending a 5-decade ban on direct travel between the longtime rivals. But the Taiwanese boat has since turned back and returned to Taiwan. It's not clear why the trip was scrapped. Taiwanese officials are blaming bad weather, but there is talk the trip was canceled for political reasons. The two nations have had no direct links since Taiwan split from China during a civil war that ended in 1949. China still considers Taiwan a renegade province to be captured by force if necessary.
The Westchester District Attorney's husband is headed to prison. Janine Pirro's husband, Albert, showed up in Florida to serve his sentence. The real estate developer was sentenced to more than 2 years in prison last June. He was convicted in a million-dollar tax evasion scam. Janine Pirro says she still plans to run for a 3rd term as prosecutor. Dozens of families are homeless tonight after flames raced through an apartment building in Elizabeth, New Jersey. The fire started about 10 this morning in a 5-story building at 105 Grove Street. It took dozens of firefighters from Elizabeth and neighboring towns to bring the fire under control. Everyone got out of the building okay, but many of the apartments were gutted. Investigators say a faulty furnace may have started that fire.
Still ahead, from crime to politics to the biggest party around, 2000 made for quite a year. In the final minutes that are left, we'll take a look back.
New York City's Mayor Rudy Giuliani was also one of the year's big headliners. We're going to talk to his honor live in just a few minutes.
And there was a blizzard in Louisiana today, and along the way, a football game broke out. Gary Apple with that story next in sports.
Tonight's Holiday Magic is brought to you by PSEG. We make things brighter.
Too.
Know how to start the new year off with a blast? Get to the two-day 2001 sale at The Wiz. Get it right at the store that knows technology. Because The Wiz has a sharp 19-inch color TV with direct access remote for, wow, just $148.88. And an Iowa high-performance mini component system is just $249.99. Want the right technology? You know where to go. Get to the two-day 2001 sale. Get it right at The Wiz.
Welcome back to the Ford Shopping Network's year-end clearance.
Yeah, time to talk Ford SUVs.
The biggest lineup of SUVs on the planet.
With no boundaries. And Ford Explorer is tough enough to take you anywhere.
And big enough to bring almost anything.
And now lease Explorer for $299 a month with $33.48 due at signing.
Oh, and you know I love the 2001 Ford Expedition.
I'll bet it's the perfect family vehicle.
Especially for my always-on-the-go gang.
And you can lease an Expedition for $399 a month with $46.14 due at signing.
That's a great deal.
Oh, man, they're both great deals.
Are you sleepy?
No.
What do you think it's going to be like?
Mom says there's even more magical stuff now.
Okay, guys, back to bed.
We're too excited to sleep.
The only thing better than looking forward to a magical Walt Disney World vacation is finally getting there. Make plans at DisneyWorld.com and make your dream come true.
You sleep?
No, too excited.
I heard that.
Closed captioning for CBS 2, provided by Toyota. Real values every day.
Well, there it is, Todd. Times Square. A whole lot of folks out there. Wow. You think it's going
to
be more?
And to think that we know for a fact that there are less people there
than last year. Exactly. That seems unfathomable.
See, the crowd's really thinned out. It looks like a great party there tonight. Who cares about a snowstorm 24 hours ago?
43 minutes exactly before.
That's right. We never really pointed that out. The countdown 2001 clock on your screen will be there right until 12 o'clock midnight. And we will
along
be here with
us.
You. That's right. This is an extended version of the weekend news. We're here until 12:05. But right now, let's talk about the Giants a week away from beating the Eagles.
Can you say that? That's the big question.
Well, I did.
Well, we know this. It is the Giants and the Eagles. 4:15 at the Meadowlands next Sunday. To the winner goes the NFC Championship game. Philly advancing with a 21-3 win over Tampa. The Bucs now 0-20 lifetime in temperatures of 40 or below, which it was today in Philly. Donovan McNabb, once again, the story for Philadelphia. Second quarter, he tucks it away. And there he goes, 5 yards for a touchdown. It was 7-3. Then final seconds, first half. This time McNabb connecting with Nate Brown. And look at the arm strength on McNabb. 14-3 Philly, and again, they win it 21-3. If you're scoring at home, the Giants have beaten the Eagles 8 consecutive times, including twice this year, by a combined score of 57-25. Here's Eagles star and former Jet Hugh Douglas, who's very aware of the Giants' domination.
So whatever it is that they got on us, we got to get our mojo working this week and correct that problem, because if we want to go any farther, we got to go through Giant Stadium.
All right, first of all, we know they have to go through Giant Stadium. Secondly, we've got to find out, guys, who made the hat?
The hat was huge.
For told him to wear it.
That's the big question. Stop the questions, though, about the Ravens' defense. It is as good as advertised. Baltimore shut down Denver, beat the Broncos 21-3. Late second quarter, and try and follow the bouncing ball here. It goes off Lewis, then to Buckley, and then to Shannon Sharp, and there he goes, 58 yards for a touchdown, gets a great block along the way. It was 14-3 Ravens at the half, and what a day for Jamal Anderson. He ran 30 times for 110 yards, just bouncing through the gut of the Denver defense right here. They couldn't bring him down. 27 yards, 21-3 Baltimore, and that was the final. And so the Ravens move on. They face Tennessee next weekend. And so, talking about Al Groh, the departure from the Jets may have not have been so sudden after all. We found out today that Groh spoke with Virginia Athletic Director Terry Holland somewhere between the 11th and the 18th of this month. That's when the Jets were in the middle of that three-game losing streak to finish the season. And so despite the fact that he didn't meet with Holland until 2 days ago, the possibility of this move had apparently been on Groh's mind for at least a couple of weeks now. The question is now, will Bill Parcells, the Tuna, retake the Jets coaching reins? Well, not if Parcells sticks to his words of last January 3rd.
I'm not going to coach any more football games. This is definitely the end of my coaching career.
All right, and so you heard it right there. Stay tuned. If you're waxing nostalgic for yesterday's blizzard, wax no more. This is the Independence Bowl tonight in Shreveport, Louisiana. Mississippi State had trouble hanging on to the football, and for good reason. I mean, this is Louisiana we're looking at here. This is a blizzard. They also had trouble kicking the football. Look at this. I mean, this was a near whiff on the kickoff. Texas A&M recovers, leading to this touchdown. It's a Ferris to Ferguson. They called it about 40 yards, give or take a yard or two. They couldn't see the hash marks. Texas A&M leading it right now, 35-28. They're in the fourth quarter. Hockey, a bad New Year's Eve for the Rangers. Less than 2 minutes in down in Dallas, the Rangers got caught on a line change, and Mike Keane would beat Mike Richter. It was 1-0 Stars. Then later in the period, it's McDonough to Sloan, and Richter simply doesn't have a chance there. Dallas beat the Rangers 6-1. Much better night for the Devils on the power play. Keep an eye here. It's Brodeur to Rafalski to Gomez to Sikora. He's denied once, but not a second time. Say goodnight. The Devils beat Columbus 6-3. NBA in Chicago. The Bulls beating the Nets 86-77. It's just the Bulls' fifth win in 30 games. The Nets are a disaster right now. First half, Elton Brand, local guy, backing in Kenyon Martin, the rookie. The soft fadeaway, nothing but Nets. Stephon Marbury trying to keep the Nets close, two of his 18. Nets still down, not at the break. Third quarter, where's the defense here? This is just awful. Brand in uncontested. Then the St. John's guy, Ron Artest, putting it on ice with the slam, and the Bulls win by 9. College ball, speaking of St. John's, they took on San Francisco. These are not Bill Russell's San Francisco Dons. We saw that today. It was not even close. 92-77, the final. Alpha Ben-Gurion, not to be confused with Beta Ben-Gurion. That's the killer crossover. You see, it took a second, guys, for that to kick in. And then it's Cook to Shaw for the dunk. Never close as St. John's wins it by 15. That's it, guys. Big Apple Sports. The final one.
For the year 2000.
Mr. Apple, thank you, sir.
Okay, guys.
The 2000 has been quite a year, especially for the Big Apple's mayor, Rudy Giuliani. Our Aimee Stone standing by live with the mayor in Times Square. You know, he throws quite a party. Aimee?
We are here with the master of ceremonies. Let me ask you, have you ever been interviewed by anybody wearing a metallic wig?
I don't think so. I think a lot of people in Brooklyn have something like that on. I think I've seen that.
Talk about a city that doesn't sleep. The sanitation department did a nice job of getting rid of all the snow.
Yeah, they did a great job. I mean, yesterday morning, the people were saying, could we have this celebration today? Snow gone, sanitation workers, transportation workers, police officers, firefighters. You got to love them. I mean, they're just great.
Nothing really compares to last year, but this is close. This is pretty good.
Yeah, this is probably the biggest that we've had other than last year, which, of course, was the millennium. And I like the idea of these balloons that they've added to it. I mean, this is the world's New Year's Eve celebration. People watch this celebration all over the world, Asia, Africa, Europe. They'll be watching at different hours. So this is like the world celebration. We unify people, I think, by this celebration.
It's a lot of pressure, you know, for one city.
Yeah, it is a lot of pressure. But, you know, this is the world city. It's the capital of the world.
And speaking of pressure, you are going to be with Muhammad Ali tonight, punching that crystal ball to signal the descent.
Yeah, I'm going to be very nice to him. I'm not going to say anything that annoys him. I love Muhammad Ali. I know him, and I have great respect for him. And I can't think of anybody more appropriate. He's someone that's probably the best-known American, one of the best-known Americans all over the world, and he's really a terrific man. He's a man of principle that you can admire, and I loved him as a boxer also. I happen to like boxing, so.
After the year you've had, how much are you looking forward to 2001?
I'm looking forward to it. I had some health problems in 2000, other problems. The city did best in 2000 probably of any time I've been mayor, so we're going to try to look at 2001 as a gift, an extra year to be mayor, and try to make New York City even better in 2001 than it was in 2000.
All right, between you and me, you got any New Year's resolutions?
Yeah, that's it. New Year's resolution is to see if we can exceed 2000, make 2001 a great year, make sure that we hold on to our position as capital of the world, and we go into the rest of the century in a very, very strong city.
Now, no offense, Mayor, but you don't look, you need some metallic, you need some, I don't know, you might want to borrow my glasses or something. I don't know. You need something, don't you think?
Think
I think that looks great. Happy New Year.
Okay.
Happy New Year.
I can see better now. I can see right into 2001. It's going to be a great year.
Happy you guys.
Those are prescription glasses.
The mayor is jiggy with those glasses. All right, we know what the weather's like for New Year's Eve, but what about New Year's Day when we're all going to be recuperating, recovering?
It's going to be dry, cold. We're going to keep the same old weather we've had for the last couple of days. We've had our excitement now.
Yes, we have.
A little break in the weather department. It's chilly tonight, though. If you're planning on stepping out, if you're watching in town, maybe thinking about heading down to Times Square, make sure you bundle up. Temperatures are in the 20s. The wind chills are below zero. Let's go ahead and take a look at Times Square again. Look at that. People getting ready. 35 minutes to the top of the hour. that we say goodbye to the year 2000. Who is that?
Father Time.
I knew that.
I thought it was Zeus.
Thought it was Zeus?
That's a big old Father Time.
Looming large.
I like that. All right, let's take a look at our current conditions, see what's going on temperature-wise around the region. 21 degrees right now in Newburgh, 27. Central Park, 25 at Belmar. The wind chill ranging anywhere from 5 to maybe 10 degrees below zero at times. In most places, it's not quite that bad. Now, let's take a look at our satellite imagery. You know what? We were right. We can't use the clicker. Hey, Chris, if you're listening to me in the weather office. Chris is taking care of me in the weather office. I didn't think our little clicker would work. Hey, look down at the bottom of your screen there. You see that blue going across the Gulf Coast states? Mm-hmm. Gary Apple showed you the video from Shreveport, Louisiana. Yeah. They're getting snow down there. They're not used to getting snow in Louisiana. I think they have one snowplow for the whole state. They had four inches in Shreveport. Up here, we just have a few snow flurries, nothing that's going to affect us at home. Weather maps for tomorrow is going to stay nice and quiet. High pressure in control. The winds will be coming in out of the northwest. It's going to be chilly, but nothing of any significance to talk about. And that's good news when the weather people say that. The forecast for tonight, partly cloudy skies, going to be breezy, cold, down to 21 in the city. It'll be in the mid-teens in our northern and western suburbs. Forecast for tomorrow, mostly sunny. There'll probably be a few scattered clouds, especially in the afternoon. Upper 20s in the northern suburbs, low 30s in the city. It'll stay in the mid-30s, maybe out across the eastern part of Long Island. Five-day forecast, good stuff, just cold. 32 on Tuesday, 34 on Wednesday. The normal high is in the upper 30s. We'll get close to that on Thursday with a chance for a few snow flurries maybe by the end of the week. So nice and quiet all the way through.
I think
the
we can handle that.
Quiet's a good word.
Yeah.
We checked on the snowplow in Louisiana. There's no gas in it, so they're in a lot of trouble.
The guy's busy.
Thank you, too.
All right.
Well, we've already told you about ringing in the new year with a real record-breaking...
Yeah. Oh, look
check
at
out that domino display.
Yeah, that's in
it
China.
It will leave you awestruck.
Yes, it will indeed. New Yorkers aren't the only ones partying it up. In just a few minutes, we'll check in on celebrations in Miami and Philadelphia. First, though, tonight's lottery numbers.
Because I'm stuck on you.
The Mercedes-Benz E-Class, available with 4MATIC all-wheel drive. Whatever the weather, these babies stick.
I'm gonna stick like glue. Stick because I'm stuck on you.
He knows. She knows. They know too. Know how to start the new year off with a blast? Get to the two-day 2001 sale at The Wiz. Get it right at the store that knows technology. Because The Wiz has a sharp 19-inch color TV with direct access remote for, wow, just $148.88. And an Iowa high-performance mini component system is just $249.99. Want the right technology? You know where to go. Get to the two-day 2001 sale. Get it right at The Wiz.
Recounts. We at Kia had our own recount of inventory and found we still have lots of 2000 models. So, we're having our sell-down event, where you'll get up to $2,500 cash back on Sportages, $2,000 on Sophia's and Spectras, plus our 10-year, 100,000-mile long-haul warranty. Overall, our recount went pretty smooth. But like the election, we, too, had a Chad problem.
9,047. Chad! Chad!
Get great deals at our 2000 model year sell-down event. Ends January 2nd.
Oh, man.
One.
Nobody.
Ever since you were a kid, you believed that life is better with a boat. That's why you'll want to attend the all-new 91st New York National Boat Show. 9 days to save big on thousands of boats. First-time boaters get advice at the Discover Boating Center. And see the 2001 Lincoln Navigator, the most luxurious way to tow your new boat. The New York National Boat Show, January 6th through 14th at the Javits Center. Because life is better with a boat.
Only once a year do we reduce our prices an additional 20 to 40%, which means the only way to beat a Men's Warehouse price is at the Men's Warehouse sale. You're going to like the way you look. I guarantee it.
News on CBS2 is brought to you by Fidelity Investments.
We're off.
That would be the new year, baby.
Once again.
As opposed to Father Time.
Right. Who looks like Zeus to me. Times Square, they've got a lot of interesting little things floating around there tonight. What's on the baby's back?
I believe that baby 2001 has a jetpack.
Ah. You know, zooming into the new millennium.
That's right, the true new millennium.
The true new millennium.
29 right. minutes, 53 seconds and counting to 2001.
Just doesn't seem like it. What happened to 2000? It has come and gone, people. Times Square, of course, is ground zero for the party of all parties.
So smack in the middle of it is MTV, part of the CBS2 Information Network.
Let's check in on the action with the host, Carson Daly. Hi, Carson.
Hey, thanks a lot, guys. As you can see, the MTV party is in full swing. There's almost a million people outside our studios here in New York, packed to the walls with people ready to ring in the new year. Here we've got tons of, like, famous DJs, celebrities, just cool people walking around. My co-host Rachel Lee Cook and I have been bringing out a steady procession of bands to play. Marilyn Manson, Papa Roach exhibit. We even piped BB Mac's performance out there to the street so that the almost million people could hear it. MTV has every entire scene covered. Even a big party at Roseland was up the block thrown by NSYNC's Lance Bass. It's the best view of Times Square. We're on until 12:30. If you get a chance, stop by. Happy New Year to you and yours.
Right. Same to you, Carson.
Thank you, Carson. Tell you, I want you to see the difference, though. We are less than 30 minutes to go to the ball drops. Mm-hmm. Now, Carson, right above Times Square.
Right.
In the jacket.
Right.
Warm.
Yep.
Comfortable.
Well, let's check out Aimee Stone with the glasses, the jiggy glasses that were just on the mayor. The wig, cold, though. Hi, Aimee.
Let me tell you, what's keeping this crowd warm is Love Shack right now. That's what they're playing to keep us warm. And they also have trivia on the Discover card board up there, like, you know, what was Times Square named after? The New York Times. Did you know that? I didn't. Look at these revelers out here. They're having a blast. It's not as big and magical as last year, but I'd say that it's pretty close. Look at these red balloons and the metallic wigs and lays that they've handed out. Here's a look at some of the people that are here tonight. You came all the way to Chicago, and you got a snowstorm and everything, so you must feel like you're at home.
Yes, I do. We brought the snow with us.
Yeah, thanks a lot, buddy. Where are you from?
Italy, from Bologna.
Is it your first time in New York?
Yes, we just arrived this afternoon.
Wow, how do you say Happy New Year in Italian?
Buon anno.
Buon anno. Oh, sounds so much more romantic than Happy New Year. Okay, so how do you say Happy New Year in Romanian?
La mulți ani.
La mulțian.
La mulțian.
La mulțian.
La mulțian.
La mulțian.
La mulțian. You know, I'm a quarter Romanian, you know. Do I look it?
No, you didn't look.
No? Oh.
No. Right. 新年明けましておめでとうございます.
Oh, forget it. I'm not even going to try that. Yeah. Where are you? Where did you guys come all the way in from?
All the way from Long Island.
Long Island.
Long Island.
That's Long not drive. Far away. How do you say Happy New Year on Long Island?
Happy New Year. Feliz Año Nuevo.
Okay, that works. Where are you from?
Manchester, England.
Manchester is your first time in Times Square?
Last year we came.
Oh, so it's you do this every year?
No, last October, and came for New Year this time.
Oh, isn't it lovely? All right, the celebration is heated up here in Times Square. As you can see, they brought out the puppets that they had last year and flags. And they've handed out the red balloons to all these people who've been sitting out here, standing actually, for the last 6 hours waiting for that ball to make its 77-foot descent. We'll be here. I'll do my best impersonation of Dick Clark coming up. Back to you guys.
Aimee, we like you better than Dick Clark.
Much better.
He doesn't have glasses like that either. Thank you, Aimee. Check back in a bit.
Well, there are other big bashes going on tonight. Forget about the snow. We're going to head to the beach. It's got to be hot, hot, hot at Miami South Beach tonight. I'm sure everybody down there is on South Beach. There's a concert under the stars there, and that's where we find one of my former colleagues from our sister station at WFOR, Lisa Cabrera. Lisa, this time last year, I was on South Beach. You were in Key West. Can you believe it's been a year?
Can you believe that? Can you believe we are together again? Angela, you are sorely missed by everyone in this
miss
town,
you guys
just
too.
So you know. Well, as you can see where I am, you know, Angela, we're about 20 feet away from the sand. No snow, we have sand, but we are right near Ocean Drive. That is the main thoroughfare down South Beach. It has been shut down for this giant street party to welcome in the new year. Literally thousands of people making their way to South Beach to see a live performance under a tent right on the sand. The B-52s are performing. Boy George is performing. That concert got underway just about 30 minutes ago. People, as you can see, are bundled up a little bit here compared to up where you are. I know it's nothing, but we do have wind chills on South Beach in the upper 30s for people who have thin blood down here. That is rather cold, so people are bundled up, but many people not deterred, put it that way. The streets here are flooded, shut down until 7 o'clock this morning. Next, tomorrow morning, the new year. Angela and Todd, I'm going to send it back to you.
You know, Lisa, I remember last year it was cool there because I had a leather jacket on, and I remember what you had on last year. What are you wearing now? It looks like, what is it, a fur?
It is not fur, it's faux fur.
Oh, okay.
I want to make that clear.
Well,
no
I do.
Letters. Yeah, we're bundled up. Everyone's got layers on. We've got wind chills really in the 30s.
Yeah.
So the little skimpy black dress doesn't
right.
do for tonight on South Beach.
All right, Lisa, tell everybody hi there at WFOR and Happy New Year to you, honey. Okay.
Happy New Year to you.
Okay, babe.
And to those folks in Miami in coats for New Year's, as we get ready to party here, hundreds of people are working around the clock to get ready for tomorrow's Tournament of Roses Parade. The New Year's event features floats covered in roses. Hundreds of volunteers do the painstaking work of gluing the flowers into place. The 112th parade will have 52 floats and 24 marching bands.
And in Philadelphia, the big New Year's Eve party is at the waterfront at Penn Landing. People have been staking out their spot along the Delaware River so they can get a good view of the midnight fireworks. I know it's going to be gorgeous. That's where reporter Beth McDonough is live. Beth.
Well, good evening, and Philadelphia is definitely shining tonight. The city certainly putting on a celebration fitting for the real millennium. It is complete with parades, pyrotechnics, and parties. And as you mentioned, the countdown for our fireworks extravaganza is on. The sky will sparkle right over the Delaware River here at straight up midnight when those fireworks do go off. And as you can see, the crowd is definitely starting to grow on Penn's Landing there right along the waterfront. And I can tell you, actually, it's a bit of a trifecta celebration for us here in Philadelphia because not only are we celebrating the real millennium, but we are also celebrating the 100th birthday of our City Hall, which is the huge mammoth structure in the middle of Center City here in Philadelphia that most people know because it has Billy Penn on top of it. Also, of course, the Eagles won the first game of their playoffs today, so a trifecta celebration. And our hoopla actually started very early this morning with the Rocky Run, which, of course, is unique to Philadelphia. And although Sylvester Stallone was nowhere in sight, some 500 Rocky Balboa lookalikes that put on their gray sweats, and they ran up the steps of the Museum of Art, so we're having a big blowout here in Philadelphia.
All right, Beth, and listen, congratulations to the Eagles, and tell them to celebrate in Philadelphia tonight, because next Sunday is going to be a whole lot different.
Oh, I'm sure.
Thank you, Beth. They're coming to the Meadowlands.
Yeah.
Straight ahead, a Domino's Delight, the beginning of 2001, setting a new world record.
And we'll keep checking out Times Square as the clock counts down and the excitement builds. This is the CBS2 Information Network. Is that...
At Nissan, we're saying so long to the year, and you get the goodbye. It's Nissan's goodbye sales event. For 10 days only, get an extra $500 cash above current incentives when you purchase or lease almost every new Nissan. Get a new Maxima, Sentra, Pathfinder, Quest, or Frontier pickup with an extra $500 cash. Or an Altima with a total of $1,900 cash back. Hurry, on January 2nd, your chance for up to $1,900 cash says... Nissan, driven.
Join the 100,000 New Yorkers who are having a less taxing time this year saving for college. And now choose from new investment options.
New York's college savings program is easy, and she can use it at any eligible school in the world.
We put money in our grandchildren's accounts at birthday.
And we get a New York State tax deduction.
Open your account by December 31st.
And get a New York State tax deduction.
Just call our toll-free number.
Or visit our website.
Imagine the returns.
If you're watching Brett Favre on an ordinary television, you're missing a lot of action. Get a Mitsubishi widescreen HD TV with a picture so real, so clear, you won't miss a thing. Get a Mitsubishi HD TV and pay absolutely nothing for 12 months.
Didn't hurt.
Get it right at The Wiz.
Find
finding your dream home and protecting it. Ensuring the future for your family. Investing for your most important goals. Millions of people build their future on the strength of Prudential. Which piece of the rock do you need today?
My resolution, to have more fun.
I'll spend more time with my family.
This year, I'll save money.
Make good on these resolutions. Get to the Chrysler year-end event.
Lease Chrysler Town & Country, the best minivan ever. From the family of minivans that have won more awards than any other. Get $1,000 cash allowance on Town & Country or $750 cash allowance on Voyager. The Chrysler year-end event.
You are watching a very special edition of the Weekend News Now, a weekend countdown to the year 2000 on CBS 2. That's Times Square live.
And that's a lot of people.
It sure is. And in the corner of your...
Todd, I saw the flag of Texas. What was that all about?
They know you're here. Angela being a Texas native. And a countdown clock in the corner there. You see it, 19 minutes, 25 seconds to 2001. And there's baby 2001 again with that rocket
baby
pack.
Scary looking.
On his back.
Yeah, look at him. Zooming into 2001.
Any minute now. Down under, Sydney Harbor turned into a showcase of fireworks to welcome in the new year there. An estimated 1 million people turned out to see the fireworks explode over Harbor Bridge. Big party not only kicked off the year 2001, but signaled the start of another celebration in Australia. January 1st marks the 100th anniversary of the Federation of Australia. There will be a big centennial celebration all year long down under.
London rang in the new year almost 5 hours ago. Thousands of cheering Brits gathered at Trafalgar Square. Cold weather forced officials to cancel other New Year's Eve events around the country, that is. Even so, London does plan to go ahead with its New Year's Day parade tomorrow. Why not?
And a different kind of celebration. Tens of thousands packed St. Peter's Square tonight in Vatican City to hear the Pope's New Year's message. In his midnight address, the 80-year-old pontiff wished for peace and prosperity for the whole world. The Pope will celebrate New Year's Day Mass tomorrow.
Well, China started the new year by breaking a world record for dominoes. This is neat. A group of students from China, South Korea, and Japan toppled 3.5 million dominoes arranged in a very elaborate pattern. Take a look.
F-R-E!
Start!
中文写的新年好，那么日语呢是明けましておめでとうございます，新年好。韩语呢是在海普马尼帕多塞欧，也是新年好的意思。最后是五个四块，注意这块的衔接，一个小跳梁过来以后。 突然，前面的牌过来，然后主线非常准确的第一时间把这个衔接接上了。这前面的墙壁突然一下倒塌，后面呈现出一切顺利，继续往前走，加油！大家知道空气当中的这个阻力呢，显然没有水中的阻力那么难。这里边水往前，水里边的这个排往前倒的时候是非常的困难的。这时候掉下去以后，正好掉下来，贝壳飘来里边。
好了，这里的，然后前面走的是一列火车，在跟著名的古牌赛跑。这列火车是北京开往中国的国旗，中国的国旗飘起来了。我们再来看看下一幅，这里我们亚洲树都根连根，我们亚洲云也手握手。
It certainly was. And I want to point out, with 16 minutes and 10 seconds to go to the new year, no other New Year's Eve show is showing you that kind of excitement. Still ahead tonight, we have another live report on the passengers stuck at the airport this New Year's
Eve. Bless their hearts. Plus, we'll take you back live to Times Square for more on the countdown to 2001. It's upon us.
Ooh.
not the shoes that you wanted.
The Lexus, December to remember sales event.
Your car, sir?
You'll find values you never believed possible.
A tent.
You like it?
Pull it!
The December to remember sales event ends January 2nd. Missing it would definitely spoil the surprise. See your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Lexus dealer.
He knows. She knows. They know too. Know how to start the new year off with a blast? Get to the two-day 2001 sale at The Wiz. Get it right at the store that knows technology. Because The Wiz has a sharp 19-inch color TV with direct access remote for, wow, just $148.88. And an Iowa high-performance mini component system is just $249.99. Want the right technology? You know where to go. Get to the two-day 2001 sale. Get it right at The Wiz.
Stories that touch you. Sources that will teach you. CBS 2 reports. Compelling stories from the world's most informed sources. Coverage you won't find anywhere else. Weeknights on the News at 11.
The CBS 2 Information Network.
A message from Verizon Wireless.
Optimum Online. What are you waiting for?
Very well-qualified returning Daimler Chrysler lessees can lease a four-wheel drive Dodge Durango for just $369 a month. There's still time to give in to one last temptation.
We've intentionally eliminated Father Time from our live shot.
He's scaring me.
He's scaring Angela, but we're down to 13 minutes and 5 seconds to the brand new year. They're dancing, singing, and whooping it up in Times Square.
Whooping it up indeed. You know, it's hard to believe that, I guess, 500,000 more people were there last year. What happened to 2000? where did it go? It's been an exciting year, though. It has.
We ended up here.
We ended up here, and that ain't half bad, folks.
Not too bad. All right. It's hard to believe it'll be almost over in a few minutes, but the Millennium Party that kicked off the year to the unexpected events that shaped it really changed everything. What a year it was in the news as well. CBS 2 reporter Lou Young takes a look back.
Y2K arrived with the biggest party Times Square had ever seen, a 24-hour event that heralded the new millennium from every time zone on the planet. Who remembers if we ever believed the apocalyptic predictions? But weren't we all a little relieved when midnight passed and disaster hadn't struck? The first national obsession of the year was already in the works that night. Elian Gonzalez had been in the U.S. since Thanksgiving. The struggle between his Cuban father and Cuban-American Miami relatives would last until June. This wouldn't be the last time we'd look at Florida and wonder what the heck was going on down there. Which brings us to presidential politics. Remember New Jersey's Bill Bradley looking so promising early on? But he got crushed by the Al Gore Express, which derailed down in Florida on Election Day. So there we were in Palm Beach.
Complete hand recount.
And in Tallahassee.
A million ballots here.
And finally in Austin, Texas, with the new president-elect who takes over January 20th. As George W. Bush moves into the White House, Senator-elect Hillary Clinton moves out. This was the year in which a sitting first lady ran for office and won. The president and Mrs. Clinton moved to Chappaqua this year. She ran for the Senate, recruited by the Democrats to stop Mayor Rudy Giuliani from taking the U.S. Senate seat, then defeating Long Island Congressman Rick Lazio in the election. The mayor, meanwhile, had a year he'll never forget. His Senate hopes evaporating, along with his marriage to Donna Hanover, almost at the same moment he was diagnosed with prostate cancer.
I think I'm in good hands. I have a very, very good doctor. I'm going to talk to other doctors as well. And we caught it at an early stage, and we'll just have to deal with it.
Across the river, there are dramatic political changes. Democrat John Corzine is the new U.S. senator after writing personal checks for $60 million to fund his campaign. And Governor Whitman heads to Washington as the new EPA chief after watching her popularity plummet during the ongoing controversy over racial profiling by state police. It was generally a bad year for police in the area of race relations. The trial of New York City officers who shot and killed Amadou Diallo by mistake on his doorstep ended with not guilty verdicts and acrimony, as other officers took the life of Patrick Dorsmond on a Manhattan street in a mix-up over an undercover drug operation. Crime was down, but we were horrified by occasional explosions of violence. like the Wendy's massacre in Queens.
It probably was the worst crime scene that I've seen.
And as we are every year, we were reminded too often of just how dangerous police work can be.
I not only lost a fellow cop, but I lost a damn good brother.
It was a year when killers discovered getting rid of the body doesn't make for a perfect crime. Dr. Robert Birnbaum was convicted of killing his wife 15 years ago and dropping her body in the ocean. The cops don't know where Irene Silverman's remains are, but Sante and Kenneth Kimes were convicted of murdering her.
Tower right here was on fire in that building. Since then, it spread all.
As fellow New Yorker Billy Joel points out, we didn't start the fire, but we watched it burn this year from the New Jersey waterfront to the skies over Paris. Some may remember 2000 as the year a wondrous machine fell from the sky, suddenly all too fallible. But the fear and apprehension fade with memory. Let's cling to the hope and excitement we felt in the early days of autumn when two teams from New York played each other for a world title. This was the year the Subway Series returned, reminding us of stories our fathers told us and suggesting that the halcyon days of their youth are perhaps not so different from our own. Happy New Year. Lou Young, CBS 2.
And still ahead tonight, we'll take another live look at the party in Times Square,
where the excitement is certainly building for the big ball drop.
I'm Marcella Palmer at Newark International, where stranded families are packing in their New Year's Eve plans and preparing to stay at area hotels. I'll have more coming up in a live report.
Welcome back to the Ford Shopping Network's year-end clearance.
Yeah, our first item is the 2001 Ford Focus.
Oh, we're talking roominess, folks.
The biggest interior in its class.
This is a very cool car.
Now lease one for $189 a month with $2,864 due at signing.
Next up, the 2001 Ford Windstar.
The five-star safety-rated Ford Windstar.
Oh, you mean a quadruple five-star safety rating for front and side impact crash test.
Well, it's got over 40 standard safety features.
And now you can lease a Windstar for $299 a month with $1,999 due at signing.
Boy, these are going fast.
And they'll be gone soon.
In this bottle of Behringer, a 125-year commitment to making great wine. From the only winery ever to win Wine of the Year for both a Cabernet and a Chardonnay. In this glass, the perfect complement to your own special moments.
Mom, remember when you said you were too young to be a grandmother?
Whatever they happen to be, Behringer, all we are in every bottle.
When I evaluate a company, I ask myself, would I put my own money in this company?
I see no reason to buy the stock in here.
This is not a job that's done well behind the desk. We go out doing the field work that the individual investor does not have time to do.
The inventory was in terrific shape going into the fourth quarter.
My job as an analyst is not just about buy recommendations. It's about not being surprised by anything. At the end of the day, we just want to do what's right for the investor.
Toyota Thon 01. Get to this blockbuster event for great year-end values on Toyota trucks and SUVs. Lease a full-size Tundra for $219 a month, 36 months, $1,719 at signing plus taxes and fees. Or buy a Tacoma and save up to $1,070 with cash back and options discounts. Toyota Thon 01. Oh, yeah. It's back at your Toyota dealer now.
Well, look at that. 6 minutes, 38 seconds before, look how pretty that ball is.
Just absolutely beautiful water from crystal all lit up from the inside, and it is gorgeous.
And Muhammad Ali is somewhere around there ready to do his duty to God and his country. The greatest he is indeed, and he's going to be a big part of tonight's celebration.
They look like they're having fun to me.
Yes, they are. Well, all three area airports were shut down, as you know, by the snowstorm yesterday, but flights are running again.
But no real fun right now. When you have a massive shutdown like that, it can take 24 to 48 hours to catch up on all those canceled flights.
Marcella Palmer is live at Newark Airport with the latest for us. Marcella.
Well, Angela, Todd, less than 10 minutes to the new year, and people stuck in New Jersey for the new year, well, they aren't going to bring it in at home like they planned. Instead, they're going to bring it in at area hotels, and they've unhappily made that decision, left the airport, gone home. That's where they're going to be. Now, the arrival and departure boards at Newark look clear to me, but the Port Authority still says there are residual delays, even cancellations at all three airports, Newark, LaGuardia, and Kennedy delays, which may last well into the first day of the brand new year. A bit of controversy today when Mayor Giuliani took to the sky and snapped some pictures of the condition of Kennedy's tarmac, still snow-covered. It looked like the North Pole hours after the snowstorm. His office mailed those pictures to our newsroom computer. Now, yesterday, the mayor blasted the Port Authority for not being more cooperative. The PA says Giuliani's comments are just unwarranted, but families who are still trying to get home could care less about the back and forth between Mayor Giuliani and the PA. They just want to go home, which they are not going. At this hour, most have given up, and they're trying to book flights instead for tomorrow or Tuesday, and they're ringing in the new year, like I said, in hotel rooms right here in good old New Jersey and over the Hudson. Everybody have a happy new year wherever you are. Reporting live from Newark, Marcella Palmer for CBS2.
Marcella, you do the same. Happy New Year
to
you.
Yeah.
You are dismissed.
Yes, you are dismissed.
Tough weekend.
She has indeed. And so have you.
Well, not yet.
Oh.
I got one more thing to do. Hey, you know what? I know
what?
That Times Square is packed. You know why?
Why?
Because there's four people left right over here watching us out here. Can you believe there are people?
Hey! That's okay. God bless them. Those
who
are watching us here.
Times Square inside. We're down to 4 minutes and about 20 seconds.
All right, let's take one last look at the weather. We know it's cold tonight. Temperature is going to be in the 20s with wind chills below zero. There's another look at the ball getting ready to drop, counting it down there. I want to see another shot of Father Time so we can scare Angela. I kind of thought it looked like Superman in his golden years, you know? A little beard. Who's that?
Some
Snoopy.
Yeah, it's a snowman.
I don't know. All right, let's do some weather.
Yeah.
Let's do that. Temperature right now, 26, Central Park, west wind at 13, gusting to 20. And just because I can't think of anything else to talk about, we're going to look at some New Year's Eve past. The weather's not bad now, but imagine if we had 2 inches of rain, like back in 1888.
Lord have mercy.
They had 9 inches of snow back in 1869. It was four below in 1918.
Good night.
But it was 62. In 1966. How about that? That would have been a good New Year's Eve.
I wasn't born yet. Sure. Oh, Todd cleared his throat.
All right. Tony, thank you much. Still ahead tonight. Buddy. It is minutes. How many minutes? 3 minutes.
Yep.
23 seconds and counting to the big moment.
Get ready to toast. We're taking you back to Times Square for the big ball drop. You're watching the CBS2 Information Network.
No matter what you need, you can count on dependable, long-lasting Chevy trucks. Make your money count on a 2001 Chevy Silverado half-ton extended cab with as low as 1.9 APR. Or get $2,000 cash back on a 2001 Chevy Blazer four-door after a $500 bonus offer. Residency restrictions apply. So make your money count at your local Chevy dealer now.
It's great. This morning I lived like this. And now I can live like this.
Hey, baby. If I'm not the man of your dreams, I don't know who is.
I do.
Perhaps an aperitif, my dove?
TD Waterhouse. Transfer funds between brokerage and bank accounts. Even pay bills all online. How easy is this?
Premise. Take one of the best-selling cars in America. Add extra features like an automatic transmission and air conditioning. Include a 6-speaker stereo cassette with a CD player. All offered to you at some special savings. It's called the Accord Special Value Package from Honda. And it's proof that you can have your cake and eat it too.
For a limited time, get special APR financing as low as 2.9% for 36 months on new 4-cylinder Accords.
A 1 minute and 1 second away.
Is that Muhammad? There's Muhammad Ali and the mayor. Yeah, there he is. The greatest. Yes, he is.
Oh, ready to pull the switch.
That ball is gorgeous.
You cannot have the waterfall crystal ball, Angela, when they're done, by the way.
Oh, doggone it.
That will be used for many years in Times Square.
I so wanted it.
You cannot own that.
Look at this, Todd. 43 seconds. My goodness. I'm starting to get tingly.
All right, well, we're going to tingle more in the year 2000. There are all revelers out in the middle of Times Square on a chilly night. Who cares about a snowstorm 24 hours
That's
ago?
That's right.
We're down to 30 seconds away.
That ball has been lit up in all beautiful colors tonight.
And no more arguments about when the millennium starts, because now...
Who cares? This is it.
Whether you thought it was last year or this year, we're in it now.
We're in it.
15 seconds.
Uh-oh, confetti's starting to rain down, and Todd, we're going to have to do the honors of counting down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1! Muhammad Ali. Look at that happy child. I tell you, what a year. It's going to be a great year. I insist on it.
Right on cue.
Right on cue.
Here comes the ball drop.
Yay! What a great place to be for the new year, you know?
It's the only place to be.
You better believe it.
Forget those folks down under who celebrated a long time ago.
That's right.
New York City throws the best New Year's Eve party.
Oh, I like that.
And right on cue. Those are not actors we hired, folks.
That's the real deal, Holyfield.
That's right.
Oh, well, Aimee Stone has been out there for quite some time covering it all. Aimee, this is fantabulous.
I'm sure she's covered in confetti now.
You know,
Aimee?
I've covered a lot in my life, and this is the first time I think I've cried on television. I don't know. It's something that's Times Square is so sentimental.
Yeah.
It's beautiful, and it's my first here in New York, and it's wonderful, and everything went off without a hitch, and Times Square is being littered by confetti, but I'm sure the sanitation department will do just as good a job of removing it as they did the snow. Happy New Year, everybody. Happy and healthy one to everybody. Back to you guys.
Same to you, sweetheart. Same to you.
Just beautiful, beautiful sight in Times Square tonight. Whether there are 500,000 people there or a million or more as last year, it really doesn't matter.
You know, I've watched this celebration many years in many different places, but there's nothing like being right here.
Hey, 2001's been good to that man already.
I should say. Probably going to get better for him. A lot of confetti. Big hug there. Said he really has a great deal of admiration for the greatest.
Thank you, Giuliani, for joining us earlier this evening. I hope you heard from him, his remarks, and how much he loved Muhammad Ali.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's a special moment for the mayor after the year he has had.
Mm-hmm.
He's standing up there celebrating the year 2001 with the greatest.
That's right. How apropos. Nice way to begin the new year. Are you going to make any New Year's resolutions?
You know, I keep those a secret.
That's good. I don't make them. I made one for the first time last year. I did it on TV, and I didn't keep it, so I'm not. That's it for me. That's it for me. No more New Year's resolutions. I'm wondering about the crew, though. You guys made New Year's resolutions?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they're not telling either,
exactly.
By the way. Those of us who had to work here at New Year's Eve, I'm very glad that you've decided to tune in and spend these exciting moments with us to start the new year.
That's a huge crowd down there. Are they estimating 500,000?
I counted them individually.
Uh-huh. What'd you get?
A little bit
Did
earlier.
Did you feel a clicker thing?
I came up with a little bit over 500,000. I'll get you that exact number in just a moment.
More fireworks. Come on.
Right on cue.
Right on cue. Ask and ye shall receive. What a year it's been. What a year for New York.
And as we all know, 3 minutes into the new year, that the celebration, in a lot of ways, has just begun tonight.
Yes.
For a lot of those folks.
And for a lot of us, too. Oh, nice, nice.
So hard to believe that Times Square was buried in snow yesterday. We saw the pictures. We were on the air yesterday afternoon.
Yeah.
They were beginning to clear it, beginning to get the snow and the ice off. Had those big snow melters out there, and they made a lot of room for a lot of people tonight.
It just made it all so magical, though. Nice little flurries, nice foot of snow the day before, all cleared for all the guests we've had from all over the world. They've come here to see this extremely special event here in Times Square. Wow. Well, tomorrow's the big cleanup.
Which we are not going to participate in.
No.
We'll leave that to the sanitation folks.
And they did a fine job
yesterday. New York's strongest. We'll be back in action tomorrow.
Wow. When you see this from all different angles, it just seems unbelievable. And we said this earlier, that twice the number of people were here last year. Seems unfathomable.
We want to thank our sister stations, both in Philadelphia and Miami, for their help tonight, as well as MTV and Carson Daly for joining us.
More smooching.
You know,
That's my kind of New Year's,
buddy. I don't think they're doing it for the camera at this point.
No.
I don't think that they're doing that for posterity at all. Because we're almost 5 minutes into the new year.
Yes, we are.
And they're
are.
Still kissing.
And there's Father Time just for me.
Just for you.
As we get ready to wrap things up and let you enjoy the beginning of your new year. Back home in Texas, my folks will be having black-eyed peas and cornbread. That's a tradition for New Year's. I know a lot of you have a lot of traditional foods you're going to eat for New Year's Day tomorrow. I'm just going to sleep.
All right. Well, I wonder what Aimee Stone is doing now. I know she's still got those glasses on. Aimee? Aimee, are you there?
I was just going to say, if you want to come to me.
Yeah. Well, if you
we have.
Me, we have come to you.
Oh, hello. I didn't
Go
know
ahead.
You were. Looking around trying to find somebody to kiss. Oh well. 3,500 pounds of confetti Jeez. Right now falling on Times Square along with a sea of red balloons. It's quite a sight.
Aimee, can you hear us?
I can hear you.
I'm wondering, because you and I talked earlier this week about this assignment of yours, is it everything you thought it would be?
It is. You know, I was supposed to go to this restaurant, and the ovens broke down, so that would have been the worst. And I say this is the next best thing, right? Working on New Year's. I'm actually getting paid for this,
yes.
which is pretty cool, right?
It's a good gig.
It is a good gig sometimes, isn't it, Angela?
Indeed. Happy
hey,
New Year
by
to
way,
you.
By
yes,
the way,
dear.
What are your resolutions? You guys got any?
Not
saying.
Yeah. It's best not to.
No but more junk food. No. That's mine.
I want you to resolve to turn in the receipt for those glasses, though, okay?
Happy New Year, Aimee. Start spreading the news. All right. Well, I think we're going to say goodnight.
I think we probably should at this point.
All right. That's CBS 2 at 11 for this Sunday night special edition. We wanted to bring in the new year with you. Happy to do it. I'm Angela Ray.
I'm Todd McDermott. For all the latest news, be sure to tune in to the news this morning starting at 5 here in CBS 2. We wish you a very safe, happy, and prosperous 2001.
We're going to leave you with a live look at the party in Times Square. Have a very, very blessed year. Be careful.
Good night.
Looks like our first potentially major storm.
During.
Can you say shutdown?
The roads are extremely dangerous.
Please be very, very careful.
About 11 and a half inches on the ground.
And after the holiday storm.
Times Square is looking pretty good.
Nobody brought you more coverage than the CBS 2 Information Network.
The CBS 2 meteorologists were right on target.
So be prepared when the next storm hits with David Rogers and the entire CBS 2 news team. Everything you need to get through the storm. The CBS 2 Information Network.
My resolution, to have more fun.
I'll spend more time with my family.
This year, I'll save money.
Make good on these resolutions. Get to the Chrysler year-end event, where select lessees with exceptional credit can lease Chrysler 300M for $389 a month with zero down and $789 due at lease signing. This resolution, you want to keep. The Chrysler year-end event. Hurry, offer ends December 31st.
Now, here's a company that might be worth our while.
Hold your horses, Marge. First, we do research.
Welcome. Our company's a safe bet for investors with excellent growth potential. Over the past five
years... Screw the potential. Let's see some product.
As you can see...
With iBeam's interactive streaming media, you can connect with people in ways only a face-to-face meeting can match. Ivy, streaming the best of your business.
Yes?
I'm here for your DLJ Direct upgrade.
Upgrade?
Where's your computer, please?
That's over there.
You see, DLJ Direct is tapping into the strength of Credit Suisse First Boston to form CSFB Direct. Now you can invest online with more award-winning research, more global resources, and more IPOs.
It's impressive. Will this take long?
Not at all. Enjoy the power, sir.
Introducing CSFB Direct, coming online January 15th.
Happy New Year to you and your family from all of us at CBS2.